My talk today will be about the detection of liver lesions. Liver lesions are either hypervascular lesions or hypovascular lesions. The best way to diagnose liver lesions is to use a triphasic study, either by CT or by MRI. Before explanation the meaning of triphasic study, I have to remind you that the liver has dual blood supply. 80% of blood supply is coming through the portal vein and 20% of blood coming through the hepatic artery. What is the meaning of triphasic study? Triphasic study is the imaging of liver in three phases: arterial phase, portovenous phase, and delayed phase. This is triphasic study for the abdomen. After injection of the contrast media, the liver starts to enhancing gradually, and because the liver is taking 20% of his blood through the hepatic artery and 80% through the portal vein, as I mentioned, so the liver is showing mild enhancement in the arterial phase and reaching its maximum homogeneous enhancement in the portal phase when all the contrast in blood reaching it through the portal vein. So what is the arterial phase? Arterial phase means imaging of the liver after 35 seconds from the start of intravenous contrast administration, when the contrast reaching liver through the hepatic artery. So this is the aorta here, and this is the celiac trunk. This is the celiac trunk, and this one is the hepatic artery. So when the contrast reaching the liver from the hepatic artery, it takes about 35 seconds from the start of intravenous contrast administration. In this phase, we can detect any hypervascular tumor in the liver. And also in this phase, we can appreciate enhancement of the renal cortex, as you see here. We can appreciate mottled enhancement of the spleen, as you see here. We can also appreciate enhancement of the pancreas, as you see here. So this is the arterial phase. What is the portovenous phase or portal phase? Portovenous phase is imaging of the liver after 35 seconds from the start of intravenous contrast administration. When the contrast reaching and enhancing all the liver parenchyma, as you see here. So in this phase, we can appreciate complete enhancement of the liver parenchyma, and here very easy to detect the hypovascular tumors, which appear as hypodense lesion. So this is the liver here, which is showing marked homogeneous enhancement. Delayed phase means imaging the liver after 5 to 10 minutes from the start of intravenous contrast administration. In this phase, we can detect enhancement of the fibrous tissue contents of some tumors like fibrosis and cholangiocarcinoma. Also, we can detect the fibrous capsules of some tumors. And also in this phase, which is very important, we can appreciate the washout of the contrast from the malignant tumors, as I will tell you later. So this is the delayed phase. Here you can appreciate excretion of the contrast from both kidneys. This is the right ureter and this is the left ureter, and the contrast is seen inside the ureters and in the pelvic cell system. The liver lesions are either hypervascular lesions or hypovascular lesions. The hypervascular lesions are better detected in the arterial phase because they get 100% of their blood supply from the hepatic artery. So they appear as hyperdense lesions on a background of little bit hypodense liver parenchyma. The hypovascular liver lesions are better detected in the portal phase, when the normal liver parenchyma enhances maximally, and these hypovascular tumors will be visible as hypodense lesions in a relatively hyperdense liver. Nearly all the liver masses are hypervascular, except the liver cysts, liver abscesses, and hypovascular metastatic lesions. In the delayed phase, the malignant tumors showing wash out the contrast more faster than the normal liver parenchyma, appearing hypodense in a background of more brighter liver parenchyma. Don't forget, the washout sign is one of the important signs of malignant behavior of the tumors. Also, any fibrous tissue showing delayed enhancement, so the fibrous containing tumors like cholangiocarcinoma and the fibrous capsules of some hepatic tumors are showing a significant enhancement in the delayed phase.
This is the selected cuts from the upper abdomen with intravenous contrast administration, arterial and portovenous phase, arterial phase because the contrast is intensely enhancing the aorta. And here we can appreciate the hepatic veins and the portal veins good enhancing in the portovenous phase. So in the arterial phase, we have two hypervascular lesions appreciated because of their intense enhancement in the arterial phase. In the portovenous phase, both lesions showing marked washout faster than the adjacent liver parenchyma, appearing in the portovenous phase as hypodense lesions. So this is the meaning of washout of the contrast, which is behavior of malignant tumor. This is another selected cuts from MRI and CT. These two cuts from MRI upper abdomen and these two cuts from CT of the upper abdomen. How can you differentiate between MRI image and the CT image? Look for any bone structure. The bone structures in MRI is black or hypo-intense, and the bone structure in the CT is hyperdense or bright, as you see here. So the spine here is black or hypo-intense. So this is MRI image, and the bone here, the spine is hyperdense or white or bright. So this is the CT image. Anyhow, here in MRI image, this is arterial phase and this is portovenous phase. The contrast is intensely enhancing the aorta. We have hypervascular lesion here in the right lobe of the liver. Here in the portovenous phase, we have marked washout of the tumor more faster than the adjacent liver parenchyma, become hypo-intense in the portovenous phase. So this is the behavior of malignant tumor. The same tumor is appearing here in the CT as also hyperdense lesion here in arterial phase and also in portovenous phase showing a marked washout. These are selected cuts from the liver in plain study, arterial phase, and in portovenous phase. In plain study, a regular nodular outline, pictures of cirrhotic changes of the liver. In arterial phase, we have hypervascular lesions appreciated by its hyperdense appearance in the arterial phase, and here in the delayed phase, you see the washout of the contrast become hypodense in comparison to the adjacent liver parenchyma. So this is the behavior of malignant liver lesion, and this is example of hepatocellular carcinoma. This is a very good example for the retention of contrast in a fibrous tissue of a tumor. This is selected cuts for the liver in plain study. This is with arterial phase, this one is portovenous phase, and this one is delayed phase. This is a case of cholangiocarcinoma compared between the mottled enhancement in the arterial phase and the enhancement of the fibrous component of the tumor in the delayed phase, as you see here. So another example for enhancement of a fibrous capsule of the tumor. This is arterial phase, this is the delayed phase. Arterial phase because the contrast intensely enhancing the aorta. Here we have hypervascular lesion appearing as hyperdense structure lesion seen in the right lobe of the liver, and compared with the delayed phase, we have complete washout of the tumor denoting its malignant behavior. At the same time, we have marked enhancement of its fibrous capsule. This is illustration for triphasic study. This is the liver here, hepatic artery and portal vein, and the three lesions in the liver. This image in non-contrast study, you know, 20% of the blood going through the hepatic artery. So this is the arterial phase. Arterial phase showing enhancement of hypervascular tumor of the liver, as you see, and still the liver is a little bit hypodense. In arterial phase, we appreciate also enhancement of the pancreas and the mottled enhancement of the spleen and the enhancement of the renal cortex. In portovenous phase, when 80% of the blood going to the liver like this, causing complete enhancement of the liver, as you see here. Here the hypervascular lesions little bit visualized, but we have good visualization of hypovascular lesions in the form of hypodense lesion and a background of bright liver. In delayed phase, the contrast washed out from the liver parenchyma and only the fibrous containing tumors showing a marked enhancement in this delayed phase.
The differential diagnosis of hypervascular lesions are either primary hypervascular lesion or metastatic hypervascular liver lesions. The primary hypervascular liver lesions either benign or malignant. The benign hypervascular primary liver lesions are hemangioma and focal nodal hyperplasia and adenoma. The malignant primary hypervascular liver lesions is the hepatocellular carcinoma, including the fibrolamellar hepatocellular carcinoma. Regarding the metastatic hypervascular liver lesions, we have to know first that 80% of metastasis to the liver are metastasis from hypovascular tumors, and only 20% are metastasis from hypervascular primary tumors. The primary hypervascular tumors are about only 9, which are thyroid carcinoma, choriocarcinoma, malignant melanoma, malignant pheochromocytoma, islet cell tumors of the pancreas, carcinoid tumor, renal cell carcinoma, leiomyosarcoma, and 15% of cancer breast. So this is everything regarding the detection of different hepatic lesions by CT and by MRI, and in the next episodes I will discuss each one of these lesions in a separate episode. Thank you very much.